In this video, we're going to be taking a look at loop components in Microsoft Teams chat. So loop components can be found at the bottom of a chat in this toolbar here, where you'd find like your emojis and your attachment options. So we're going to click on it. And loop components are essentially something that everyone in the chat can edit at the same time. So there are some kind of similar options like bulleted list, checklist, numbered list, task list. They're all just various types of lists, really. There's also the paragraph option and an option to do a table. So I think I'm going to have a look at the table option here. So I'm going to do a 3x3 table, and that will start syncing. So let's just give it a name of events for 2022. And then it gives you the option here. So people in your organization can edit, people currently in this chat, people with existing access, or specific people. So if you're in a group chat, I guess this might be handy. So if you're in a chat with clients, then maybe you only want people in your organization to be able to edit the table, or you only want specific input from specific people. And then I'm just gonna hit send. So that's now sent the loop component, and over here you can see the time that I last edited it, and then this little button here you can see who has access, so people outside of this chat with the link will have access. So at the moment it's us two, but if I then copied the link and sent it to someone else, they would then have access to it. So then you can just start editing it as you would a Word document or an Excel spreadsheet. So if I just put date and time there. And then now you can see that Sam's initials have appeared, and that means that she is in the chat now and she has highlighted this square here. And we can see live as well that she is typing in this box too. So this is really handy actually to just be able to collaborate with people within a chat. Another loop component we could try is a task list. So here we can put tasks. The same options again at the top, we can choose specific people to have access to this, and then you can just write your tasks in. So write agenda, and then you could assign someone in the chat. So to do this, you'll want to put an at symbol and then click their name, and you can select a due date for them, and then let's just send that loop component there. And we can see again that Sam has now appeared here in the loop component. You can also see at the top here that she has the file open and she has just ticked off this task from the list. So that is a look at the new loop components feature in Microsoft Teams chat.